Well, hello, kids. Mayor Rick Chrest here, and another in our continuing series of a few books that the mayor is reading to students, because I know you're at home doing your best to keep up with your studies. And since I can't come and meet you at school, and I love to read to students, I thought we would do it this way. So I hope you're enjoying them. Here's another classic by Robert Munsch with artwork by Michael Marchenko. And it's called Something Good. Tyra went shopping with her father and her brother and her sister. She pushed the cart up the aisle and down the aisle, up the aisle and down the aisle, up the aisle and down the aisle. Tyra said, "Sometimes my father doesn't buy good food. He gets bread, eggs, milk, cheese, spinach, nothing any good. He doesn't buy ice cream, cookies, chocolate bars, or ginger ale." So Tyra very quietly snuck away from her father and got a cart of her own. She pushed it over to the ice cream. Then she put 100 boxes of ice cream into her cart. Tyra pushed that cart up behind her father and said, "Daddy, look." Her father turned around and yelled, "Yikes!" Tyra said, "Daddy, good food." "Oh no," said her father. "This is sugary junk. It will rot your teeth. It will lower your IQ. Put it all back." So Tyra put back the 100 boxes of ice cream. She meant to go right back to her father, but on the way she had to pass the candy. She put 300 chocolate bars into her cart. Tyra pushed that cart up behind her father and said, "Daddy, look." Her father turned around and said, "Yikes." Tyra said, "Daddy, good food." "Oh no," said her father. "This is sugary junk. Put it all back." So Tyra put back all the chocolate bars. Then her father said, "Okay, Tyra, I've had it. You stand here and don't move." Tyra knew she was in big trouble, so she stood there and didn't move. Some friends came by and said hello. Tyra didn't move. A man ran over her toe with his cart. Tyra still didn't move. A lady who worked at the store came by and looked at Tyra. She looked her over from the top down, and she looked her over from the bottom up. She knocked Tyra on the head, and Tyra still didn't move. The lady said, "This is the nicest doll I have ever seen. It looks almost real." She put a price tag on Tyra's nose that said, $29.95. Then she picked Tyra up and put her on the shelf with the other dolls. A man came along and looked at Tyra. He said, "This is the nicest doll I have ever seen. I'm going to get that doll for my son." He picked up Tyra by the hair. Tyra yelled very loudly, "Stop!" The man screamed, "Ah, it's alive!" And he ran down the aisle, knocking over a pile of 500 apples. A lady came along and looked at Tyra. She said, "This is the nicest doll I have ever seen. I think I'll buy this doll for my daughter." She picked up Tyra by the ear. Tyra yelled as loudly as she could, "Stop!" The lady screamed, "Ah, it's alive!" And she ran down the aisle, knocking over a pile of 500 oranges. Then Tyra's father came along looking for his daughter. He said, "Tyra, Tyra, Tyra! Tyra, where are you? Tyra, what are you doing on that shelf?" Tyra said, "It's all your fault. You told me not to move, and people are trying to buy me. Wah!" "Oh, come now," said her father. "I won't let anybody buy you." He gave Tyra a big kiss and a big hug. Then they went to pay for all the food. The man at the cash register looked at Tyra and said, "Hey, mister, you can't take that kid out the store. You have to pay for her. It says so right on her nose." $29.95. Wait, said the father, this is my own kid. I don't have to pay for my own kid. The man says, if it has a price tag, you have to pay for it. I won't pay, said the father. You've got to, said the man. The father said, no. The man said, yes. The father said, no. The man said, yes. The father and Andrew and Julie all yelled, no. Then Tyra quietly said, Daddy, don't you think I'm worth $29.95? Well, of course you're worth $29.95, said the father. He reached into his wallet, got out the money, paid the man, and took the price tag off Tyra's nose. Tyra gave her father a big kiss, smirch, and a big hug. And then she said, Daddy, you finally bought something good after all. Then her father picked up Tyra and gave her a big long hug and didn't say anything at all. Well, isn't that an interesting book? Instead of coming home with a bunch of junk, he came home with his little daughter, Tyra. So hope you're all staying well. Do your best at home to keep up with school and help out around the house a little bit. So this is Mayor Chrest signing off. Tune into some of our other books as well and stay well.